Good morning, everybody. It's Sunday, 8:30 in the morning a.m., but I was up at 3, and April 1, I don't observe any of the major holidays, Halloween, Christmas, Easter, all the man-made holidays that man makes money on. I got up and read on the resurrection this morning. If you're going to read any gospel, read the Gospel of John, Cynthia. That's my favorite cuz. She's 1 year younger than me. If you know my age, then you know how old she is, but I won't say her age on YouTube. I read the last two chapters of John, and the overview is, I'm just going to do a bunch of talking here. I don't think I'll read too much scripture. There's a couple blue windows or blue boxes. Speaking of blue, I have my Base Your Life on Christ t-shirt on. I'm sitting on the sidewalk in front of my world-famous barbershop. There's Barber right there. And it's a Michigan day. That is the sky up there. Overcast and cloudy. Michigan day, no blue skies here in Phoenix, Arizona at Northern and 19th Avenue. Things went well last Thursday for the Shua players. I'm the Shua singer. Love, light, and truth, and honesty. That's what Shua, that's what the secondary meaning of Shua is. Love, light, truth, and honesty. For those who love truth and consider themselves some degree of spiritual, you need to come and see what I write on my whiteboard. I'm going to bring a whiteboard to Thursday night. Live music, 2 hours, 6 to 8 o'clock at the Love of Chocolate Coffee House. And I'm trying to talk him into getting a malt machine. Milk, chocolate milkshakes and malts. Mmm, yum. Anyway, and that would be Felix Garcia, the owner of Love of Chocolate. And Mac, his sister, does all the chocolate artwork in the kitchen. She's good at it. Yum, yum, yum. All right. In the last two chapters of the Gospel of John, if you're going to read any of the Gospels, start with John, okay? Because John is in the top three writers of New Testament Scripture, Paul, Luke, and John. Wrote the most words, verses, letters of New Testament Scripture, with Paul being in the lead with 13 plus 1. And read his last 6 plus 1, half of the 14, all of them that end with grace be in the last verse of the letter. Grace be. Those are the letters you start with, especially Ephesians, the third chapter. It's written to you and I, the Gentiles. This is the name of God in Hebrew on my hat. The Yod, the Hey, the Vav, and the Hey. 10, 5, 6, 5. And if we add two vowels, it could be actually in Hebrew, it's Aleph, which has the one value. And then there's Alpha, the Greek A, Alpha and Omega, but there's the Aleph and the Tev. So we could, the 26 plus 2 is 28. So somewhere between 26 and 28 is the numerical value of God. I wonder if they fed into the Bible code 28 instead of 26, if any of the prophecies would come out different. All right, what you're looking for in the last two chapters, read it on your own at your own speed. But write this down on a 3x5 card or at the top of the page on chapter 20. Peace be, three times, like grace be. Peace be. Lovest thou me, Peter, three times. Peace be, three times. And follow me, either two or three times. Could be three. All of those could be three. And we have two times risen. Or one time risen, but it is about the resurrection from the dead, that which they didn't put on the end of the Passion. That's what I was really upset with Hollywood and the producers about, when you watch the movie The Passion, they gave like a blip, a flash of 2 or 3 seconds, the Lord walking by, seeing the back of his hand pierced. He's alive. But there's 40 days that he walked on the face of the earth, appearing unto 500 at one time and making things right with those disciples that turned away from him before the cross, including Peter. He restores them, reinstates them in the 40 days after the resurrection. I want to make this point really slow and clear. We're thankful for his precious body, flesh, flesh, body, flesh. Those words are always together. Body, flesh, or flesh, body. We're thankful for the body, flesh. We are thankful for the blood, life, breath of life in the blood, blood carrying oxygen, blood, life, spirit, soul, breath, nephesh. Whole bunch of teachings right there, 3 or 4 teachings. Ever heard of the word nephesh? And he became a living soul or a living nephesh, air-breathing creature. All right. And what was I saying? Through and beyond the cross to the resurrection. He said, I am the life and the resurrection, when he raised Lazarus, because Mary and Martha, and the two sisters, Lazarus being their brother, and it was either Mary or Martha that was talking to the Lord and said, oh yes, Lord, I believe in the resurrection at the last day. He says, I'm going to show you the resurrection right now. I am the life and the resurrection. So that's what it's all about. So we have people walking by on the sidewalk behind me. Okay, so through and beyond the cross to resurrection life. Quickened your mortal body, quickened and made alive now. 7 minutes of that. So you read the last 2 chapters of the Gospel of John. Now the Spirit told me to go to Hebrews 10, which I'm flipping there in my super giant print Bible I have in my lap here, as the Harley motorcycles are going by and the rail and people walking by, because I'm sitting on the sidewalk in front of my world famous barber shop, the barber shop, out here on a cloudy day in Phoenix on Sunday morning. And I turn to Hebrews, the 10th chapter. Now in here, the 10th chapter, 10:5, 10:10, 10:20, body, flesh, but put the two of them together. Body, flesh, flesh, body. All right. And that flesh body, if you don't believe that the Son of God was sent, came in a flesh body, you're Antichrist. You're over against Christ. Antichrist. Also in the 10th chapter, I marked with lines an overview, Hebrews 10. You turn there. He came to take away sin in 4 and 5 that I said. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifices and offerings thou wouldest not. God doesn't want sacrifices and offerings anymore. He wants the sacrifice of praise, not animal blood or human blood. Done. Human body and human blood. Done. Once for all, forever. All right? Sacrifice and offerings thou wouldest not. I'm reading King James. But a body thou hast prepared for me. Body, flesh, temple, clay cup. We are the living clay cups that hold the word in the spirit and give witness and testimony. Yeah. Hi.
I'm trying to keep my
family. I have no money to give away today. I'm using my last money to do my wash. Thank you. And so that's verse 5, body, flesh. Okay. Now we go to verse 10. Then said he, lo, I come to do thy will, O God, to take away the first and establish the second. The second, the part 2, the new covenant, the new testament. Part 2, the second, to take away the first, the old testament, the old covenant, and establish the new, the second covenant. Verse 10, by the which Well, we are sanctified through the offering of the body of the Lord Jesus Christ. I add Lord, once and for all. And here's the second time we find body, and I add flesh, body, flesh, in 10:10. Then you go all the way over to 10:20, a new and living way, life, not blood death here, cross and death, but it's blood life, nephesh, air-breathing creature, all right? A new and living way, which he hath consecrated for us through the veil, that is to say, his flesh body. He gave, and now it's through and beyond the flesh body. And having an high priest over the house of God, household, family, house of God. And we go down here to verse 24. We're going to end at 11 minutes. And let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good doings. Speak truth, Ephesians 4:25 and add 15. The number one good doing is speaking truth with your neighbor, not giving away money to people that have no money and are out panhandling on the street. And I was honest with him. I'm living on my Social Security. I don't have any extra money. I'm down to my last $9. I'm doing wash, and I have no money to give away today. God bless you on this Easter. I covered my mouth. Do you know that in the New King James, they took the word Easter, they took the word Easter out of the Bible, the one and only time you could find it in the New Testament. I think in the Old King James chapter 12, in bold letters you find Easter, but in the New King James, they took it out because Easter does not belong in the Bible. Queen Astra or Ishtar is a pagan fertility goddess, a pagan belief and religion, bunnies, eggs, rabbits, and the mother harlot of Babylon and her princesses in the temple that do sexual things is not good. You should not observe Easter. But if you want to read about resurrection and do it on Sunday, that's a good thing. All right? Love you. This is B-Period Eugene Bear in his old, sweaty, funky, this is my oldest hat with the sacred name of God on it, sitting on the sidewalk in front of the barber shop on Sunday morning at 8 a.m. doing his wash and giving you a teaching on the out of the Gospel of John, the last two chapters, and read chapter 10 of Hebrews about the new and living way, second part two, which we should be reading and studying. And all the Christians are stuck in the Old Testament and in the Gospels trying to decipher parables that are written for outside people. They're not even written for the believers. He speaks in parables so they won't understand what he's saying. Love you. Bye.